What's going on YouTube? Back with another one. Got an exciting one today. Exciting for me anyway. Today is the first day that delayed harvest is over. So for now you can keep, in Virginia, you can keep trout out of all sections of the river here in Roanoke. But there's two stretches here in Roanoke River that you're not allowed to keep trout from. I think it's January 1st to May 31st. And today is June 1st. Which is also my sister's birthday, so y'all wish my big sister a happy birthday in the comments down there. But we're going to flick around some spinners today. Going to get y'all mounted on the chest. We're just going to flick around some spinners, some soft baits, whatever. And then if we don't catch anything, we'll probably end up going and getting some worms and cheating. But I'm going to the zoo today with my family, so I only got about an hour and a half to fish. So see y'all on the water. All right, guys, show you what I'm throwing. A little brass spinner. I actually found this. Got a little bit of residue on it because my tackle box got wet, but here's what I was talking about. Oh, wait. Oh, trout license required. Artificial lures only. May 31st. I'm gonna walk down here first. This guy fishing the other side. Shoot, a bunch of stuff in the water. Recently had a tornado through here. Something was trying to follow it. Walk up this way a little bit. Try not to bust my ass. Oh my God, the water is cold. It's only about 60 degrees right now. One just jumped right there. Fix my camera angle. What the heck? First fish of the day. A little rock bass guy. Not going home. Ow, he finned me. Not going home skunked though. He's barely hooked. All right. See you, bud. All right, walking through what looks like snake-infested grass. I'm actually gonna go straight out of this. Up a tad. All right, we made it up here. Look at all these little minnows. There's so many of them. Maybe I'm using the right bait. Cast it and got snagged immediately. Cast it right on top of that log. some people up there got a stringer full of trout. Just missed one. Guys, moved down river some. Just realized I'm running out of time. It's already 10 something, and I have to meet my family at the zoo at 11. So I'm running low on time. So I already made up my mind. If I don't catch anything before the zoo, I am going to go to Walmart and get some power bait and some worms and come back out. All right, guys, last couple spots right here before I gotta go meet the family. Looks like there's already folks down here fishing. I think this is going to be our last stop. For a little teeny tiny rock bass. All right, guys, I'm back. For y'all, it was just a couple seconds. For me, it was like 4.5 hours. So I went to Walmart. Show y'all what we got. Got some fire bait, some pouts, however you say it. Everybody says it differently. I don't even know how to say it. Smells like garlic. And then I got some green power bait. Smells like power bait. And then I got some red worms. So we're gonna re-rig our pole up here, and I'm back up at the bridge where I first started. Cause I'm a little salty that those people went and caught like 5 trout right in front of me right after I left that spot. So I'm gonna get my swim trunks back on, get y'all mounted on the chest, and be back out there. All right, guys, we're back under the first bridge. Show y'all what I got rigged up once I get over here. All right. Significantly warmer now. When I was out here earlier this morning, it was only like 60 degrees. It's now like 83. Oh, somebody's trout guts. Assuming that was the people that was up here earlier. Ooh, water is still chilly. All right, let me get in this water a little bit and I'll show you what we're doing. Okay, water feels kind of good now. All right, so this is what I got going on. For two reasons, one because I hate tying braid, and two because I think the trout can see it. I have a 4-pound leader tied on, so we have to be significantly like super, super easy with these fish if we hook anything. Got a little egg sinker there. That's probably, I'd say, 4-foot leader to a little teeny tiny hook.
And I think what I'm going to try first is this fire bait. Just because I see it on social media so much. I want to know what it's about. I know it smells god awful. I know it's a little bit more than that. That is a really large ball of dough bait. Probably could have used a little less than that. Alright. I'm going to cast it up and let it float down. Little smallmouth right in front of me. I wonder if y'all can see him. Alright guys, we are under a bridge. I have no idea what y'all are gonna see because this day has been all over the place. Got a red worm tied on with like a 4 or 6 pound leader with a split shot right above a barrel swivel. Gotta fish this part of the bridge real quick. If I don't catch anything, I'm going on top of the bridge so I can fish the other side, and then I'm gonna fish that away because I've pretty much fished this whole section of river with no trout. My worm to shreds. I'm gonna leave it little. Maybe they'll just grab the hook this time. I think they just took the tail off. Alright, gotta put a fresh piece of worm on there. Alright. See if we can get something with a fresh piece of worm. Oh, got a bite. Feels super little. They already stripped my hook. It's gotta be something tiny. I'm just getting snagged. I feel like I'm wasting worms. There goes my lid. Now we just got a ball of worms on there. Oh, got one. a little brookie. I'll take it. Ooh. Dang, he choked it. Okay, well, I don't have a stringer. Let's see if I can rinse this guy off. I wonder if that was trout messing with me the whole time.
I literally had to throat rip him to get the hook out. It was all the way down in his stomach.
One little fish. See if I can rescue my lid from down here. God, it's muddy. All right. See if we can catch another one. All right, so that method seemed to work. Just a bunch of worms on one hook. I'm still recording. My hands are filthy. Get down here and rinse them off. There's so much fresh stuff in the water from that tornado. What the heck is this? This is like a huge thing of bubble gum. And got a chatterbait out of that. Cool. What is this? Oh man, he choked it. Alright, well, unfortunately I had to break the line with the hook still in his gut there. I don't like doing that, but what are you supposed to do? Hopefully he made it. Oh man. Something grabbed it while I was reeling it in. Alright guys, probably wondering why I look different, why I'm inside my house. That'd be because it's been a few days. I fished for a long time that day. I caught an absolute ton of fish, but I think that trout was the biggest fish I caught the entire day. So I debated on whether or not I was going to show y'all that whole day. Had a pretty cool interaction with a guy who said he's going to subscribe to the channel. We seen some big trout together off the bridge. Wasn't able to catch them. But during editing, I figured out that I didn't have an outro. I forgot to shoot my outro. And then I also still have the fish that was in the freezer. And me and my girlfriend are a little hungry, so we're going to have a little midday lunch, and I'll show you guys what we're doing today. Alright, this is what we're doing. I'm going to cook that trout on the grill. I'm going to do it away. I've never done, but I've seen people do it on social media, and it makes me want to try it. So, get rid of that part. The pepper's got a little bad spot in it. We'll just nick that part away. I'll try to, anyways. Put that to the side. Take the sticker off. Try to take the sticker off. Pepper's on its last life. Last little bit of life. Had a little baby pepper inside of it. That's pretty cool.
chop it up into pretty small pieces. It doesn't take trout very long to cook, and I want vegetables to be done at the same time as the trout. Take this onion, chop them up like this. Turn it on its side. Not super tiny pieces, but like a big dice. Or, yeah, I think that's the word. Sorry if you can't hear me very well. My washer, dryer, and my dishwasher are all going at the same time right now. Alright, here we have our trout. It's been defrosted. Get it in frame real quick. Get him up on a chopper block. All we're gonna do is take the head off, take the guts out, leave the skin on. Head gone. Put that in the garden later. Now we're gonna take our big old knife, cut right along the belly there. And then we're gonna take this line out right here. That's the fish's kidney is all that is. All right, gave the fish a rinse. This is really nice meat, even though it's been frozen for a couple days. A little white there, but on the inside, everything's nice and orangish pink. So all I'm gonna do with this trout is the same thing I do every time. Slice. Maybe we'll do one right here too. Three slices on this side, slice. Slice, and then boom, trout is ready for some seasoning. Let me wash my hands, I'll be right back. Okay, so what we're doing here, putting our fish on our tinfoil, with all the vegetables around it. Should have done this first. All up here, move all the vegetables around, shove some inside of there. Yeah, alright. Now, I'm gonna wash my hands off again. Alright, now all we're gonna do is make a little boat type deal out of this so no juices can come out. This is just some olive oil. I'm gonna go pretty lightly on that. And then we got a pinch of salt. I'm gonna pour some in my hand. I just do like this. Pepper. We got some garlic. With our hands. A little bit of lemon juice. I'll see y'all outside.
All right, guys. Crack open a beer. Beer of the day is a banquet. One of my favorite beers. Not really cold enough yet. Not sponsored. Alright. As I said in my last video, don't judge my grill. She's a rescue. Alright. Got our fish and our vegetables and stuff in our little boat. I'm going to put it on the top and let it cook for a while. And then I'm going to do some sausage dogs too, but it's not the important part. See y'all in a minute. Alright, I'm back. Doing some sausage dogs. They're already open because I took two of them out, put a Ziploc bag to save because we're just not gonna eat all six of them. We're not like super starving. It's only lunchtime, you know. We're just having like a Sunday brunch type thing. Got the grill on ultra low. Gonna bump it up a little bit now. And we're gonna get these dogs on here. Oh my god, I almost lose the first one. So I'm trying to find new ways to cook fish because I don't really like fish that much. Which is one reason why I'm doing it this way. I'm really picky on the fish I eat. There's like four or five types of fish I'll even eat. So like I'm trying to figure out new ways to cook it. Sun chip! Sorry about that. My back door's open just to my screen door. My cat put his claws in the screen and started trying to, I guess, get out. He likes being outside sometimes. But anyway, we're gonna let these cook for a little while. The grill's on super low, so the dogs may take a little while. They're not the highlight of this video anyway. Well, I'll get the trout done and take a bite for y'all and let you know if I like it. And if y'all have any fish recipes, whether it be trout or any other type of fish, let me know, because I'm trying to, I guess, explore the fish world. I discovered that it's maybe not so much that I don't like fish. It's that people just don't know how to cook. And every fish I've had has been by people, or, you know, has been forced as a child or something. Like, I had to eat it to get up from the table or whatever. You know, so, like, I just didn't like it. But as an adult, turns out I kind of like it. You know, they say your taste buds change as you get older. Whether or not that's true, I don't know. But we'll see. See y'all in a minute. All right, guys, just checked on the trout. I'm going to try to flip it over in the little boat thing. It's cooking faster on one side because I can't flip the whole deal. Oh, yeah. There we go. Flawless victory.
Woohoo! That's hot. Oh, my God.
Oh, man, it smells so good. Here we can get that back into a somewhat of a boat.
See y'all in just a couple minutes.
All right, guys. What the heck happened? You're leaning for some reason.
Why are you leaning like that?
Get back over here.
My ground's not very level, if you haven't noticed. But anyway, pretty sure the trout's done. The dogs are done.
Getting burnt because I went inside. Honestly, that's perfect. I like them a little charred. This one's maybe a little too much, but I'm gonna peek at this trout. Coming right off the bone. Right off the bone. Just because my girlfriend's not feeling well and probably doesn't want a camera shoved in her face right now. I'm gonna show you what she looks like in the little boat deal. Feels right off the bone, as you can tell, it's perfectly done. Looks good, smells great. It's gonna be delicious. I'm gonna take a bite out here on camera before I go inside and enjoy this meal with my girlfriend. A little lunch and grab a pepper and some onion, a little bit of garlic pieces. And I'm gonna let you know whether or not I actually like recipe or not. I've never done it like this. I copied another recipe I seen online. I forget the guy's name. But he did it with saltwater fish. So, piece of trout, piece of onion, piece of pepper. Can't even taste the lemon juice. The onions are top notch though. Yeah. I'd say that trout's pretty good. A little orange meat on there. Pretty good. Anyway. I want to thank you guys for watching, liking, subscribing, doing all the things you do. Keep me motivated to make these videos. This one was a little plan, kind of all over the place.
But if you made it this far, drop me a recipe. Drop me something to try on my fish. Maybe it's a sauce. Maybe it's a way to cook it. Maybe it's a seasoning. Maybe it's, you know, anything. Anything to do with fish specifically, just because I'm trying to get, trying to broaden my taste buds. And, you know, so hit me with something. But anyway, thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, comment, share it with a friend. And I'll see y'all in the next one. Golden Gill out, baby.